the truth serum. Everyone loves to either hate on this product or claims that it has transformed their skin. In today's video, we're doing an ingredient deep dive. So I've got all my notes and basically going by step to look at what's inside of this ingredient list and understand and dissect how it might work, biochemistry, how it's going to interact with our skin, and whether or not it's going to work for you. So again, this is from Ole Henriksen. I pronounced it always as Ole, that's how I read it, but it's technically Ole Henriksen, and they call it a collagen-boosted True C Complex Truth Serum. Essentially, this is a vitamin C serum, and they don't say this on the packaging, but they should, but it actually has multiple forms of vitamin C that are both light stable as well as oxygen stable because some of those ingredients. Remember, you always gotta turn to learn so you can learn what's in there and see how it's going to work for your skin. Now, a lot of people say that this has transformed their skin, especially people who deal with pigmentation, who need more brightness, or who deal with some of those issues have really benefited from it. But a lot of people are also pissed about this product because of the fragrances and the ingredients. And again, let's get scientific. We're gonna break this down. Also, I match, totally unintentional, but like, I don't know, I just have to give myself a pat on the back. When I match my truth serum. And I'm also going to speak about my personal experience with the product. And as you can see, girl needs a face wash. I've been up since 5 a.m. It's been a very, very long day. But first, let's get to these ingredients. Now, I want you to remember that ingredients are listed from order of highest concentration down to lowest concentration, except for when we get to that 1% line. And I've actually debunked the 1% line on this before, but it's really high up there. So most of the ingredients in this product, I have a feeling, are at a very, very low amount. But let's dig into what they are and how that works. The very first one is water, agua, pani, again, whatever you'd like to call it. That's pretty good. The second one is glycerin. Again, glycerin is very, very smoothing to the skin. It is a hydrator. It's why we have this nice firmness, this nice slip that the product has. Then we do have Oleth 20. This is, again, an emulsifier and a surfactant. So surfactants work to bind things together that normally wouldn't want to be, such as water and oil. I always use the analogy of salad dressing. If you put salad dressing, oil and water, you shake it up, they're always gonna separate. A surfactant actually goes in and makes sure that those two things are combined. So that's super awesome and super helpful, and it also gives this emollient slip. Now the next ingredient is super exciting because this is our sodium ascorbyl phosphate. This is our vitamin C, and this is actually a very stable form of vitamin C. Super stable, and it's not light sensitive, and it's also water soluble. So the fact that we have water in here and this is water soluble is excellent. Again, I always say look for vitamin C in a light protected bottle. This is just frosted, so people are like, oh my God, it's not gonna protect. But when you look at how many forms of vitamin C are in here, and there's actually a UV light blocker in here, it is a very, very stable form of vitamin C. I think it's one of the best you can find, but there are others out there. And again, we are going to talk about my personal experience. But for now, what you need to know is that it's water soluble, it is stabilized, and it is really high up there on this list, which we love. Girls gotta love that. Next is hydroxyethyl cellulose. This is really awesome, and it's basically a thickener. Cellulose is actually what's found in plants, especially think of celery. What makes the celery stand up? It's cellulose. It's kind of that fibrous stuff. And hydroxyethyl cellulose is kind of giving this product this kind of sticky feel. I'm just gonna apply more because why the hell not? The super thickeny feel is pretty darn good. It goes onto the skin well, and again, it's really giving this its texture because in this formula, we see a lot of salts and then we see a lot of water. And if it weren't for these thickeners, this product would be really, really runny. So it's a good thing that it's in there. It's plant derived, it is wonderful. Then we've got phenoxyethanol. This is something we've spoken about quite a bit. People have been afraid of parabens. This product is paraben free. Parabens have become kind of a buzzword. There's new research showing that they might not be as bad as we think, but a lot of natural brands or good brands decided we're not gonna use those, we're gonna use something else instead. Phenoxyethanol is a very aromatic alcohol, and it works as a preservative, essentially. Now, it can cause irritation in some people, and for some people that can happen over time. I don't know if I like it worse or better, more or less than I like parabens. I don't know. But it is natural. Again, natural does not mean good. Because lead is natural doesn't mean you should go seeking out like lead or asbestos, right? But phenoxyethanol, if it doesn't bother you, it's essentially a natural preservative. Then we have capsaicin glycol. This is very skin conditioning, again, why it smooths on nice, and it's also an antimicrobial or antibacterial, I believe it's antimicrobial. Agent. So this is acting as a natural preservative. Anything that kills bacteria or that kills fungus or yeast helps naturally to preserve a product. So that's pretty good. We then have hexylene glycol. Hexylene glycol is soluble in water, so it's a fine ingredient to have in here. Then we've got citric acid, again, more vitamin C. This one is not as stable, but citric acid, again, like the other vitamin C in here, high in antioxidants. It's technically an AHA acid, so it's mildly exfoliating, but it really gives you that brightness, that beauty, which is what we're paying $50 for, right? Then we have perfume slash fragrance, and this is where everyone freaks out because they see that fragrance so high up on the line. They think that it's horrible and it's going to destroy your skin. Remember that past 1% mark, those can be mixed in any order. And we've actually done a video debunking fragrance. Sometimes it's used for the smell. Sometimes it's not. It can be used as a carrier molecule. It can be used as a trade secret. It's kind of like a secret weapon. We have done a video on it. I would highly encourage you to watch it. But what I want you to use is your common sense and your nose. When you smell this, it smells like oranges. What is that? You know those sodas that you get out of the vending machine that are like orangey creamy, like those popsicle type sodas? That's basically what it smells like. You know you're a raw vegan when you confuse an orange creamsicle for oranges. But it does have this soda orangey smell, which smells pleasant. Again, it is not a perfume bomb. It doesn't smell like six grandmothers in the perfume area of a department store, but it does have that scent. So we can bet that there's quite a bit of fragrance in here. But again, is it going to cause issues for you over time? If you're sensitive, don't use it. Fragrance may cause issues over time. And it's kind of a trade-off. Do you want this form of vitamin C? I really wish that they did make some of these that didn't have the fragrance, but it's not an end-all be-all in my opinion. Now, that's the other thing is that Ole Henriksen as a line just loves to put fragrance in everything. I'm like, why? They could honestly do a lot better without this fragrance. That's something that is kind of pissy, but people freak out about it. Go watch the fragrance debunking video because there is some science behind it that I think deserves a little bit of recognition. And then we have PEG-12 dimethicone. PEG-12 dimethicone is basically polyethylene glycol mixed with dimethicone bound together. And this is super, super smoothing. Dimethicone on its own is what is in a lot of makeup primers. So it's what kind of fills in scars and goes on really nicely to the skin. This is the PEG-12 dimethicone. So again, it's fine. There's not enough in here that it's gonna smooth over my scars. I really think that this is just a nice vapor permeable ingredient that sits well on the skin. Next is a super exciting ingredient. This is benzophone 4, and this is essentially a UV absorbing ingredient or a light absorbing ingredient. This is actually helping to stabilize the formula. Because so many of the vitamin C's in here are light sensitive, this actually absorbs some light or some UV rays so that those UV rays do not destroy the vitamin C. So this is an excellent thing to have in here. I think it's really, really intelligent that they included that. Then we have tocopherol acetate 2468. Who do we appreciate? Tocopherol acetate. This is our vitamin E, and vitamin E is very nourishing. It can help with scars. It's really beautiful on the skin, but remember, it also helps to stabilize vitamin C. So again, all of the vitamin C in here, super stable, super potent. And we don't see that with a lot of other vitamin C serums. We then have aroma slash flavor. I don't know what kind of flavor that is. Again, probably why it smells like orange soda. Then we have hydrolyzed collagen. Now, we have debunked collagen a little bit here. I want you to remember that collagen, when you apply it to your skin, does not intrinsically mean that your skin is going to produce more collagen. When applied topically, collagen can kind of smooth over the skin, might help with a little bit of the disappearance of wrinkles, might be a little bit hydrating. That's what I think this is, and they use it as a key ingredient. They put it on the front, but it's like, when we look at the back, it's under that 1% line. But I don't think it is horrible. Just keep in mind, it's not horrible, it's good, but just keep in mind, it does not necessarily stimulate collagen in your skin. The vitamin C in here is gonna do a lot more of that collagen stimulation, than this actual collagen will. We then have disodium phosphate. This is actually sodium hydrogen phosphate, and it works kind of as a pH adjuster. What's really interesting about the first form of vitamin C that they use is that it works best at like a pH of like 9, but that would not be good to leave on our skin as a serum. So this is a pH adjuster that is making this have a pH, a potential hydrogen level, that's a little bit more like the skin, so that it can actually be absorbed. And we do see some of these pH adjusters in here, which I think are kind of helping to make sure that this is actually available for the skin. When it comes to acids, you also have to look at the pKa level. You have to look at the pH and the pKa to understand how it's actually going to work onto your skin or how much of it is free and will be absorbed into the skin. But that is a very long video for another day. We then have polysorbate 60. This is, it's an emulsifier. It could also be used for the smell. Again, nice slippery on the face. We then have yellow number 6. Again, do you really need your vitamin C serum to look yellow? I'm not that picky. I don't care what it looks like or smells like as long as it gets the job done. But for some people, they really care. We have aloe barbatus leaf juice. Again, our aloe vera, super high in antioxidants, super soothing, super nourishing to the skin. One of my favorite ingredients in skincare. It's sad that it's not super high up on the list, but you know what? I'll take it where I can get it. We then have citrus aureum dulcis orange fruit extract. This is, again, an extract from oranges. This could be used as an antioxidant. This, I wouldn't call it vitamin C, just I don't think so because it's an extract, but it could be used as an antioxidant. But what I do think it is being used in here kind of doubles as a scent. This is probably giving it some sort of a scent, whether they put it in there to do that or not. And it also happens to be an antioxidant. So again, it's really good at helping your skin fight free radicals. If any light does get into here, this might kind of help to quell that and make sure that the vitamin C is again stabilized. We then have sodium hyaluronate. Remember, that is our salt derivative of hyaluronic acid. Super amazing, a super small molecule, so it can penetrate really, really deep, and it holds thousands of times its weight in water. How cool. Really great hydrator. It gets really deep into the skin. It is wonderful. We then have thiotic acid, which is actually alpha-linoleic acid. I don't know why they titled it on here, but I've seen this done a couple times. This is actually something that our bodies produce naturally. It's how our bodies digest carbohydrates and sugars, but within this product, it's probably acting as an antioxidant. Again, an antioxidant gives up its self so that free radicals don't do damage to your skin. So again, helping to stabilize this product naturally and also just being amazing for your face. We then have calcium ascorbate. This is, again, another form of vitamin C. I love to see that in here. And again, there's so many forms of vitamin C. I don't know why they don't tout that on the front of the product. I personally would. Then we've got some sodium phosphate. Again, sodium phosphate is found in skincare really commonly, and it's also found in food. I think it's a pH adjuster. In chemistry, people often use it as a buffering agent. Again, in here, I think it's changing the pH, the potential hydrogen, to make sure that this works well with the skin and actually absorbs where it needs to go. And I'm actually realizing my nose be shiny. Then we've got this grapefruit seed extract, which again, sounds really good. I bet you that this has some sort of a scent. I don't think it's being used for the scent because I know that it is antibacterial or antimicrobial. Again, this is an ingredient that is a natural way to stabilize a product, meaning it stops bacteria from growing or fungus from growing. Really, really awesome. I've seen it used in other skincare products before. I bet you it might have a little bit of a scent to it. And again, some of these things kind of do double duty beauty. Then we've got sodium benzoate, which sounds fancy, but it's actually found in apples, by the way. This is probably being used as a preservative. It could be giving this product a little bit of a scent as well. And then we have straight up alcohol. This is where I get disappointed. Alcohols in skincare are not always bad. Some of them are very creamy and emollient, so they actually give the product a more hydrating feel and slip, but this is straight up alcohol. Alcohol naturally evaporates into the air, so if I were to just leave this on my hand, some small part of it would actually evaporate off and I would have less overall. This happens a lot in your makeup setting sprays and your toners. A lot of those are just straight up alcohol. But the reason that alcohol is not always good is because it's drying. As it evaporates and leaves the skin, it can kind of make the skin feel tight or dry. And if this was way higher up in the ingredients list, I wouldn't like it. Again, I don't hate it in this product, but I think that this product could have been done in a different way without the alcohol, without some of the orange creamsicle fragrance that would make it just a lot better. But again, I get some people want that feel or they want it to smell like that, whatever. Then we have more ascorbic acid. Again, more vitamin C. I think this is so wonderful. This is packed full of vitamin C and it is stabilized. Then we have calcium carbonate, and this is just soda ash. That's all it is. Pretty sure it's being used as a pH adjuster. It's normally like a white powder. And like you don't see any impurities within this product. Like there's no graininess. I bet you anything it's being used in one of the earlier phases. Remember that skincare is made in different phases or in different layers. And I bet you it's being used to help balance out the pH, or it was already combined with an ingredient here. Sometimes when cosmetic companies try to buy their raw ingredients, some of the raw ingredients or the active ingredients are actually put into a formula that is bound to other ingredients. And that's why we end up with some of these super long lists, which is frustrating, but oh well. Then we've got calcium threonate, and I was actually very surprised to see this in here. I only know this as a dietary supplement for people who might have had weak bones, osteoporosis, broken bones. It can help. In skincare, I honestly don't know what it's doing. Maybe it's adjusting the pH. I saw an article online. Again, don't know the credibility. Again, I'm not a doctor. I don't know for sure. Might help with wrinkles, but I wouldn't put it past it. To me, it's so low here on the ingredients list. I'm just kind of like what's going on, eh? Then we have Camellia sinensis leaf extract. This is just green tea. For God's sake, just call it green tea. Green tea is amazing, really good antioxidant, really soothing on the skin. Can actually help, in some studies, it can help with decreasing oil. I have so much of this on my face right now, but I'm getting a little oily here, so. Let's take a look at my face and let's apply this. It can help to decrease oil, which is super wonderful. Get some of that sebum out of there. Also, if I ever get Botox or fillers, I don't think I ever will, but if I ever did, I could never lie to you about it because we get so up close and personal on this channel. I hope you know that you would know it. Then we have Uraphasia officinalis extract, and I had to look this up because I am not familiar with it. From my understanding and from my notes, the best thing that I could find on it for the application in skincare is anti-inflammatory, being anti-inflammation within the skin. So again, I don't know why it's in here, but okay, that's cool. Then we have rose canina fruit extract, and I am familiar with this because of how smooth it makes a product feel. It actually has like a very, very smooth jelly-like texture, like emollient-like texture, which is really nice. Might be adding a little bit of extra scent, we don't actually know, but it also has its own natural vitamin C. So again, this is chock full of this stabilized natural vitamin C, which I really, really love. Then we have potassium sorbate. This is basically a preservative. It's not a bad one, it's just a preservative. There's nothing toxic about it. Then we have benzyl benzoate, and that kind of sounds dangerous because benzoic acid is dangerous, but this is completely different, and to my understanding, this is safe. It might cause a little bit of irritation for people who have sensitive skin, but overall, I do believe it's safe. It is a preservative. It's actually a plant metabolite, FYI, so plants make this and use it within their lives. And I believe it's in here as a preservative. Then we have citral. Citral, I'm pretty sure that this is being used for scent. I had to look this up because not totally familiar with it. All I could find is that it makes stuff smell good. I'm like, okay. Then we have limonene. I love this. Limonene is super awesome because it's a carrier molecule. A lot of people see this and they think fragrance, and I understand it's used as a fragrance sometimes, but really what this does is grabs onto molecules and literally pulls them deeper, which is super awesome because it means that the ingredients, the active ones in here, potentially the collagen or the vitamin C's, can actually get super, super deep into our skin. Limonene has a really, really small molecule as well. So is it penetrating to the basal layer? Is it penetrating way into the dermis? I don't know exactly. I would love to get out like a skin model and actually test it. But we know that it is being brought really deep down. So again, why this is so efficacious. And lastly, we have some linalool. This naturally has terpenes, so it's good for the skin, but essentially it's just basically another scent. So with all of these ingredients on here, remember, most of them are past the 1% line. The ones above are the real players. And how do I personally feel about this product? I have known about this product, and I've actually had the old original bottle and been using this product for probably 4 or 5 years. I don't use it regularly, but I have to say this is one of my favorite forms of stabilized vitamin C. I think this is an excellent form of vitamin C. Those people who have tried it and say that it works so well for them, especially for people who have dark skin, who are melanin pigmented and infused, and sometimes their skin is offended easily, meaning that they're prone to pigmentation, which can be really, really frustrating. This may help to lighten that up a little bit. Again, because the limonene brings this so deep, it can get in there and do some major, major work. Now, There are people that this is not for. If you are sensitive to fragrance, if you have eczema or dermatitis, I wouldn't go near this. The vitamin C on its own can be a little bit irritating. I would not get near this if you have super, super sensitive skin to fragrance or anything. It does have a visible smell. People can become fragrance intolerant over time. Please keep that in mind. How does this compare to other products on the market? And like, is it worth like the $50 or the $60? Again, I think this is a real gem when it comes to stabilized vitamin C. And it has three forms. It's actually got like five forms in there, depending on how we count them. You see what I'm saying? A lot of other products on the market do not have that. It is one of my favorites. I just wish that there was no alcohol, and I wish that there was no fragrance. And some of the other ingredients, I'm like, why do we have so many things in here? Like, come on, we could do this a lot more efficiently. Just saying. I do still wish that it was in a dark bottle. I know that this is a stabilized form of vitamin C. I just kind of wish that. When you look at this online, it says to use it, I believe, in the morning or in the morning and in the evening. It says external use only. Apply to face and neck daily. I don't know if I would apply it to the neck as well. I guess you could. It wouldn't hurt. Don't apply acne products to the neck unless you're actually having a breakout like this. But in general, you really don't need to take things to here, but because this is a vitamin C serum, if you want some of that brightness, I think it's fine. For me, I use this at night. The reason why is because vitamin C really fights against damage, free radicals. Where do we get those free radicals? From breathing, from using bad products, but from going out in the sun. So I really like to use this at the end of the day because it helps to mitigate some of that damage. You could use it before, like under a moisturizer, like they tell you to. They're really just trying to get you to use it more often. I don't think that's totally necessary. I believe that some of these forms of vitamin C stay active on the skin for almost 3 days, which is awesome. But if you want the full potency, depending on how quickly some of the other ingredients degrade, you might want to apply this every 6 hours. If you're going to be in the sun, obviously don't use this. Use a sunscreen. This is not sun protection. It is literally a serum. But I wish it didn't smell like orange pot pie and candy. But it is a stabilized form of vitamin C, multiple vitamin C's. It penetrates well. It leaves the skin looking great. I feel like it doesn't make me super sticky. It's a little bit sticky, but it's not as bad as like one of the Tarte Cosmetics vitamin C's. And for $50, it is something that I have purchased in the past and that I still continue to purchase. I hope this was helpful. If you're interested in the fragrance video, it's right here. And if you want another video on skin science, you can watch it here. Always remember to be beautiful inside and out, and let me know what video you want to deep dive on next. Love you guys. Bye.